played Marth.
No.
Yeah.
And like at that tournament, he didn't give me the same feels that he's been giving in this era. But let's see.
Yeah, his Marth was definitely also very solid, but since P plus, he's been playing his ESS and it's been looking very strong. He played quite a bit in online tournaments as well. And well, I mean, we'll see what Knull can do with the Bowser. Obviously, quite changed.
Yeah.
Not sure how much it's going to affect them.
He's opening for Bowser here. I heard the rumblings that he would play Royal Link today. He is the Bowser. My getting much better. Trying to Ashburn.
Just going for the comfort pick, I suppose. Oh, yeah. A nice combo by Mahi here, but Knull getting out of it with the fair. Yeah, what do you think about this matchup in general? Oh!
I have very little idea about this issue.
Yeah, same. She looks like, super fast, and unfortunately, is D there.
The most prominent Zigasu player we've had in the Netherlands has been Epic Foul, but he's more of a sheet man, I think.
Yeah, I've seen him play ZSS, but...
Yeah. Oh, another... yeah, it's the Knullbits classic. But he's keeping up still. SD twice, and he's not down 2 stocks. So.
Yeah, that definitely gives you hope for the set overall for him.
Yeah, or even for this game.
Yeah, that's true.
My kind of unsure about what to do about the Bowser movement, but the Knullbits missing some of his characteristic stuff in PM. I think the tournament winner on Bowser was also changed, right?
Yeah. That's the big thing.
I heard they changed it.
But it is less good. He can't do like his classic stuff. The stuff that he really knows for, right?
The Knullbits stuff.
Yeah.
The crazy movement.
Jumping off ledge, footstooling, back on stage, hex dashing, I don't know what else in between there.
Yeah.
Just know he's super fast and I can't tell what's going on and suddenly I'm dead. But
okay, now SDing back, little bips, getting some movement going. There was a footstool opportunity in there, the classic little bips.
Yeah. Oh my god, he's still going off stage even at near 100%. No fear.
That's true.
Seriously, no fear in this guy.
Yeah.
Alright.
I can't see anything right now. The stream paused. Wow. The winner
is. Well, Mahi takes game one. But it
did
really
he?
Came down to the wire. Yes, he did. He just took it.
My Discord is fucking up. The whole thing crashed. Fuck.
Quickly reload it.
Yeah.
Before we get into the second game.
I'm doing it.
I mean.
You'll have to play by play for a second for me. How the fuck did Discord
crash? They're thinking about counter picks, I think, right now.
Was it really choppy for you, by the way?
It was getting a bit choppy, yeah. But, well.
Shit.
You've got a second, don't worry. They are doing counter picks as I said, so. But yeah, interesting game one.
No,
not the cleanest by both players, you know. There were SDs on both sides. But yeah.
I think half the stocks in this game were SDs, right? I think half
Did Mahi SD twice? I only remember one SD.
I think there's SD 3 times though, right?
Oh! Did he?
I think so.
Oh no. Well. Hopefully he doesn't SD that much the next game, and then we can get a nice game 5.
Okay, I'm back.
Alright, welcome back. Yeah,
I don't know what happened there. I've never had Discord crash on me in my whole ass life. This stream is cursed, bro.
Yeah, I don't know if it's crashed for me. But anyway, it's...
Oh, but the,
we're
the
seeing a hover.
Seems a little better for me now, so... Green Hill Zone for the
Green Hill
game.
Zone.
Mahi 1-0 against Knullbits.
That's...
This seems like a
good counter pick. I'm honestly somewhat surprised that he actually got it. I would have thought that maybe Mahi would ban the stage. Just because Bowser's able to kill so early on the stage. And...
Oh. Mai gets a pop-up. You know he does a lot of work with those impairs. This is the thing I've seen from Mai that has impressed me the most. Whenever I play Zigasu, she feels so nice to control our movement, it's so chill. You know, getting finishes going has always been a mystery to me. But when I see these Zigasu players nowadays... Oh, and Mai just
again.
Fucking Knullbits up.
But yeah, I know absolutely what you mean. It's like ZSS moves, they all very clearly are very good for comboing. You know, you've got stuff like the down air that pops them up and also pops you up, so both go the same direction. Mm-hmm. But when I actually try to play her, it's,
it doesn't do it to me when I do it first anyway.
Yeah.
We're seeing the strong finish game coming out now, and it's you need the strong finish game against Bowser. Like,
yes, Bowser is going to deal a lot of damage if he hits you. So you want to also deal a lot of damage back. By generally we're having more hits in your combo. But Bowser is quite easy to punish most of the time. It's very enjoyable.
You have to kind of watch out. He has some armor. So you have to watch out for that. You have to respect him in certain situations. But if you know where the holes in your own finish game are, you know, when you have to give that respect, I think most characters can give him a lot of percent from what he's doing.
For sure. Oh, right there we saw an attempt by Knullwurst to use that armor at the ledge. Charging smash attacks. Oh my god, Mahi's still alive.
The upper didn't kill, it surprised me.
Yeah, I mean, Green Hill Zone is a very high stage. The sides are very close, but to the top, you can really live for a long time.
It is. Even to the point where there are certain moves that you would normally not want to DI to go up. On Green Hill Zone you do, because the sides are so small. Like Zard and Pro, you know?
Oh, yeah. For sure. Okay. Oh my god, the get out attack.
Yes, the down smash. I'm the get out attack, really good. Okay, yeah, side B back there.
Oh, wow, Mayhi going way down there, but he just comes right back up with his hitter.
Yeah.
Before having a stock finished. Ah, unfortunate, another SD. But that was the only SD, right? Am I forgetting one?
I think so.
Yeah, okay. So if we're keeping up the trend, then we don't have any more SDs from this point onward. Right, we've got them thinking about the counter picks again.
Yeah, where would you go? Your Bowser against Sirisu. Do you really want the small stage? I guess you need it. You
know? Yeah, right. Otherwise, CSS is just so much faster and she can just laser you a lot. Although, I suppose there's an idea that your strong hits are going to kill on basically any stage. And maybe you can live longer because you're also quite heavy, but I don't think that would really work against Mahi. Maybe against the worst player than Mahi it would work, but
I think
you need something small because he is going to be able to finish your stocks.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, but yeah. It's hard. I think Knullabiff, he really could have had him, but he needed to not SD two times in the first game.
Yeah.
A little download happened, and I think it was bad for his own mentality.
Maybe. It is very disheartening when you knew you could have won the game and then throw it away.
You could see in that
hurts.
First game, especially that Mahi wasn't really comfortable with the matchup.
Mm-hmm.
Hadn't really seen the tricks before.
There
really isn't. I don't know of any Bowser players that I really like Knullabiff.
No, for sure. I mean, his playstyle is very unique for sure.
So he's staying with Bowser and he's going to Battlefield. I respect it. I
like
this
card.
This was game one, guys. Game one was Battlefield.
I think it was, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. I'm not 100% sure, but I think so. But I do like this pick because while Green Hill Zone is a small stage, it also has the added characteristic that's kind of like a tiny FD, right? And I don't think... Yeah, right? When the platform moves away, you sometimes have like a small SD. And I feel like the platforms might be able to help him escape combos a bit. So I like going for a smallish stage, yeah.
I think actually platforms might help, seriously.
Oh, really?
The combos, yeah, because Bowser is going to be forced to tackle them a lot.
Ah, okay.
I think Bowser's best bet to get out of the combos for these kind of characters. Like that really have a strong finish game, you know, it's not just gimmicks. They will hit you hard, they will hit you with the Bowser's best option to get out of combat is often just this nair with the armor.
Oh, okay.
Trying to get through.
Well, I can also see
I think we can, like, how you say, assume Mai's ability to cope with tech options on the platforms.
Yeah, I suppose you're right about that. Well, this game already not looking the hottest for Knolle Bibs.
No, it's really not.
We saw some nice stuff by him, like a nice power shield and a paralyzer to cut an opening, but we also saw an SD.
Yeah, he takes the stock there. There's always room for some Knolle magic, but it looks really hard for him right now.
It does look very hard, and I mean,
Mai is already acknowledged. Like the
ledge is dangerous.
Ledge is dangerous, and he gets the movement over the platform, the wave drops stuff. He's already internalized it, and Knolle Bibs.
I also think that Mai has the discipline to stay away from the ledge when he needs to.
Yeah, he's just taking top platform. He's just taking top platform in neutral when he doesn't really know what's going on and what Bowser is doing, and it's really effective.
The advantage of being up to 3 stocks to 1.
Yeah, and also
you don't have to approach if you don't want to.
He's just like, like we often call Knolle Bibs a very fast Bowser player. Like people will say he makes Bowser look like Fox. Set goes 3-0 to Mai. But Mai really showed that even with all your movement tricks, Bowser's movement is still like centralized on like tricks, you know? Like, tournament winner from the ledge, perfect waveland, wave drop, cover half the stage with an aerial.
But, and like, using the platforms as you mentioned.
Yeah, but like Zero Suit and Falcon, Fox, Spaceys, you know, characters like that, they have such versatile movement options, right? They aren't really reliant on the tricks as much as like, oh, my wavelength is just really good, my full up is really good, I have good fall speed.
Yeah.
And if you exploit that against Bowser and you just show him like I'm actually much faster than you and I can always get away, then that's gonna be better, I think.
Yeah, I absolutely agree. If you just have good run speed, good aerial drift, good short hops and full hops, that's just so much of the game. And you know, you will be able to combine these things both for like the tricks, as you call them, and for just the usual like dash dancing and stuff like that. So
just more options. Exactly. Like Bowser has access to really nice movement of the platforms, but he doesn't have a dash dance. He gets some armor to supplement his lack of movement, but if you're just keeping away from him, it can get really hard for him.
Yeah, and ZSS has the good movement with the platforms as well, but also without the platforms. So, just more good things overall. But hey, I mean, well played by Mai, definitely. You know, the first game, you mentioned it before, was super close. But Mai he overall looked like he just got a better and better understanding of the matchup. Since he probably didn't play that many Bowsers in general.
I doubt he has
more specifically
played a
Bowsers like Knolle Bibs.
Yeah, I doubt he played a Bowser that would have prepared him for this.
Yeah.
Like he just better played him.
He adapted and he took it very solidly.